Hi, Chuck Huber here for the Stata YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you how to fit an item response theory model called a two-parameter logistic model, often called 2PL for short. I'm going to begin by opening an example data set called MASC1, and I'm going to describe these data so that I can see what's in the data set. Here I have 9 questions from a questionnaire of some sort, and I'd like to tabulate question 1. And here I can see that a 1, I happen to know this, but a 1 indicates that a correct response and a 0 indicates an incorrect response to the question. So if I'd like to fit a 2PL model for these data, I can select statistics and scroll down to IRT, item response theory, and this will open the IRT control panel. I'm going to begin by clicking model here at the top left, and then from the models, the 2-parameter logistic model, or 2PL, is for binary items, so I'm going to select 2PL. And then I need to select the items below from the data set. The order doesn't matter. I accidentally clicked the 3 in front of the 2, but that's not important. So I select all of the items and then click Fit Model. And then I can look over at my in the results window, and I see that the command is IRT followed by 2PL, which is the kind of model we're going to fit. And then I see a list of all of the items that I'm fitting my model for. Next, I see the iteration history, and then at the bottom, I can see the table of coefficients. I'm going to click more so that I can see the rest of the coefficients. For question 1, notice that I have both a discrimination parameter as well as a difficulty parameter, and this is one of the defining characteristics of a 2PL model. We estimate both the discrimination and difficulty parameters for each of the items. Okay. Now, for each question, I see the coefficient as well as its standard error, z-score, p-value, and confidence interval. Now, if I'd like to change this report, I can go back to the IRT control panel and select report. And now I can sort by a variety of things. I could sort by difficulty, for example. I could sort the items in descending order of difficulty or descending order of discrimination. Ascending order is the default. I might also like to group the estimates into parameter classes. So I'm going to select this, and I don't need to select the items again. I can just leave this blank and it will show the parameter estimates for all of the items. So now if I look back in my results window, I can see that the command is estat report, comma, followed by the option sort B. So I'm sorting on the difficulty parameter, and biparm is grouping these together by parameter type. I have all of the discrimination parameters in the top part of the table and all of the difficulty parameters in the bottom part. Now, if I'd like to graph these, create graphs, I can go back to the control panel, select graphs, and I might like to see the item characteristic curves for each of these items. If I want to see the ICCs for all items, all I have to do is click submit here on the control panel, and it will show me the ICCs for all of the items on the same graph. And one of the things that we notice is that the slopes for each of these curves is different, which again is one of the defining characteristics of a 2PL model. The slopes of the ICCs are not constrained to be equal. I might want to see the ICC for only one item, so I could go back to the control panel and maybe select question 1 and click submit. And now I can see the ICC just for question 1. I might like to add a vertical line that drops to the horizontal axis so I can see where the difficulty is along the theta axis. And if I wanted to, I could compare 2 or more items. I might want to select question 5 as well and click submit. And now I can compare the ICCs and the difficulties for questions 1 and 5. I might also be interested in the item information functions. So I'm going to do this only for question 1. I'm going to remove question 5 from my list here. And I'm going to click submit. And now I can see the item information function for question 1. So most of the information for question 1 is near the center of theta, slightly to the left, because we don't have very much information on people at the high or low end of the ability scale for question 1. I might also be interested in the overall test information function, so I could select that and click submit. And now I can see the information for the entire test. And again, we see that the test information is centered near the center of theta because we don't observe a large number of people with extremely high or extremely low ability. I might also be interested in the test characteristic curve, so I could select that and click submit. And what this will do is relate the theta back to the expected test score. Remember that we have 9 items, each of which can be correct or incorrect. So the overall test score could range between 0 and 9. And so what this graph does is relates the theta, the latent variable, back to the expected test score. Okay, so that's how we can fit a 2PL model using Stata. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.